Assessing the safety of this infrastructure is quite important, especially nowadays in the context of intensification of climate stresses. In the past, the Netherlands was not used to this weather. We are getting periods of scarcity of precipitation, quite high temperature. It's a condition that the Netherlands was not actually experiencing in the past, and that is posing new challenges for our infrastructure and for our soil. A lot of these dikes are actually made or founded on very soft soil, especially in the western part of the country. We have soft clays and peat, which actually are soils that contain a high amount of water. And losing water, the soil actually shrinks. And upon wetting, when actually we have rainfall, this soil is not capable to regain as much as volume that it has lost. Understanding the dynamics of this process, which is soil-atmosphere interaction, is actually fundamental to ensure the safety and the serviceability of this infrastructure. What I have in my hand is actually a sample of peat, which is this very highly organic soil, very much present in the Netherlands, especially in this part of the country. You can imagine that the shrinkage of this sample, which means the loss in volume, could impact the height of our dikes. These houses are actually below the water level. So it's really important that we ensure that the height of the dike is almost stable in such a way that these people, and especially the infrastructure, do not suffer from flooding. And the data that we collect from the laboratory are actually useful to have models that can predict how much this material shrinks if outside we have 30 degrees or if there is a month of absence of precipitation.